An apple a day doesn't always keep the doctor away.
Why did they lie to us?
Unfortunately, sickness is inevitable. It's one of the less pleasant parts of life, and throughout history, it always has been. Getting sick used to be a life or death situation, up until the development of penicillin in the late 1940s. Now, antibiotics are used to treat everything from gonorrhea, ew, to strep throat. Also, ew. But scientists and doctors alike have started to notice a scary trend in bacteria becoming more and more resistant to these antibiotics, making these diseases dangerous again. So why are common infections like strep throat slowly going from annoying to deadly? Penicillin works by attacking the bacterial cell wall and killing the bacteria so that we humans can make a full recovery. That's why it's used to treat so many different bacterial illnesses, because it's so effective. But because of this antibiotic resistance, the antibiotics that would have formerly killed a bacteria now don't work anymore. Antibiotic resistance is when the bacteria is able to resist and survive the antibiotics that would have normally killed it. It's like they're mocking us. But how did the bacteria become resistant to the antibiotics in the first place? Well, antibiotics don't kill all the bacteria that are in your body immediately. It can take days or weeks to kill them all. So imagine that your sickness is 99% cured, but there's still 1% that remain. And then you cough on someone and you manage to pass on your illness. The disease that you're passing on is the 1% strongest bacteria, the last to die. So when that happens multiple times, you're getting the top 1% of the strongest 1% of the strongest 1% until you get these super strong bacteria that have survived all of these different attacks from antibiotics. And now they're antibiotic resistant. And this problem could be our own fault. Many reports cite that the overuse of antibiotics is one of the reasons for the increase in antibiotic resistance. People have been using antibiotics for illnesses that aren't bacteria based. So the antibiotics don't work on those diseases. Things like the common cold. It's caused by a virus, not bacteria, so antibiotics have no effect. But we always have bacteria in our system. So if you have a cold, you're taking antibiotics, you're building up a resistance to the small amounts of harmless bacteria that are around your body. And so when those now super strong bacteria get into the wrong place, they become deadly. Another way resistance is spread is when people stop taking the full dosage of the prescribed antibiotics. So you might start to feel better, but that doesn't mean all the bacteria is dead. You might still have that 1% living inside you. So if you stop taking the penicillin before it's finished, and then you come into contact with someone when you're still contagious, you're spreading those surviving bacteria who are the strongest. According to Scientific American, this is especially common in countries where people can't afford to take the full dosage of penicillin, only taking, say, half the course and not killing all of the bacteria. This leads to resistance, and it can very easily spread from those parts of the world that can't afford antibiotics to the rest of the world. So this is a problem for everyone. Essentially, this problem of antibiotic resistance is survival of the fittest at its finest. The top 1% of the top 1% of the bacteria survives and is spread from person to person, spreading antibiotic resistance with it. Overall, this increase in antibiotic resistance poses a serious challenge to our health. So it's important that we do everything we possibly can to prevent the spread of antibiotic-resistant bacteria. One easy step you can take to prevent the spread is to take all of the antibiotics that you're prescribed. And when you're taking those antibiotics, you're probably contagious, so try and stay home as much as possible. That prevents the possibility of coming into contact with other people and spreading your infection, and it also gives you a chance to binge watch more SciQ videos. Thumbs up. The second way to prevent this problem is by conducting more basic medical research. Back in the 1940s, the United States government invested millions of dollars into researching how to get this thing called penicillin into a commercially available format. And that resulted in American soldiers not dying from basic infection. More research into how bacteria work will help scientists understand more, find new antibiotics, find different ways to diagnose and different ways to treat infections. If emphasis isn't put on the research part and is just on the drug developing part, we'll be developing drugs for bacteria that we don't actually fully understand. So people are going to start dying of these diseases that we used to be able to treat. So what do you guys think? Are you now terrified of being infected with antibiotic resistant bacteria? Do you know someone that has? Are you guys gonna start taking more precautions and stay home when you're sick? Let us know in the comments below.
Hi everyone, I'm Jade Lovell, resident science nerd on the Young Turks Network. You're watching SciQ, and we know you don't wanna miss an episode, so please click the subscribe button down below.